In this video, we're going to talk about the difference between whiskey and whiskey.
Do you mean whiskey?
What?
You're saying it weird.
The difference in spelling comes from the Scottish and the Irish Gaelic forms. And in Scotland, it's spelled whiskey. In Ireland, it's spelled with an E. Now, in the 1700s, when the Irish immigrants moved to the United States, they brought the spelling of whiskey with them. So in Scotland, Scotch is spelled whiskey. In Ireland and the United States, it's spelled with an E. In this video, we're going to talk about five differences between Scottish, Irish, and American whiskey. If this is your first time watching a Top Whiskies video, welcome. You might want to consider subscribing to our channel. We post a new video every week. If you're someone that likes whiskey or would like to like whiskey, we might make videos that you'll be interested in. Now, the first difference between American bourbon, Irish whiskey, and Scotch whiskey is the distillation process. In the United States and Scotland, whiskey is distilled 2 times. In Ireland, it's distilled 3 times, which is why you hear the expression triple distillation. Triple distillation produces a smoother, lighter spirit. Now, obviously, there are always exceptions to these rules. For example, outside of Glasgow, Okintoshin makes a triple distilled whiskey that tastes a lot like an Irish whiskey. But general rule of thumb, in the United States and Scotland, twice distilled. In Ireland, thrice distilled. Difference number 2, the stills. In the United States and in Ireland, they tend to stick to one kind of still, and that's a pot still. Pot stills are short, fat, rounded stills that tend to make smooth, well-rounded spirits. In Scotland, they use all kinds of different shapes, and all those different shaped stills produce very, very different spirits. So Glenmorangie, for example, have really tall, long stills, and Old Pulteney have short, squat stills, and they all produce very different kinds of whiskey. Difference number 3, the use of peat. In Scotland, it's common to use peat as part of the drying process for your malted barley. This is done before milling and mashing takes place. This gives Scotch whiskey some of its characteristic smoky flavors. In the United States and Ireland, they use different fuels and wood to dry out the malted barley or whatever grain they happen to be using. This gives it a less smoky and smoother taste. Now, of course, there are always going to be exceptions. There are lots of Scotch whiskies that don't use peat. And for example, Connemara uses a great amount of peat and produces some fantastic smoky Irish whiskey. But again, general rule of thumb, in the United States and Ireland, they don't use a lot of peat. In Scotland, they do, and it produces a smokier spirit. Difference number 4, the use of grain. This is the difference that gets me the most excited, because to me, this is the difference that links to the land and the history of these countries. In the United States, in Ireland and Scotland, they all use a different kind of grain to make their whiskey, and I think that's really cool. In Scotland, you almost exclusively find malted barley. Most whiskey, Scotland, malted barley. It's part of the definition of Scotch. In Ireland, they use a mixture of different grains. So they might use malted barley, but they're probably going to mix it with other things. And you might ask yourself why they do that in Ireland, but it connects to the economy and the history of Ireland. Historically, the economy in Ireland has been a little bit behind that of Scotland, which means that they had to use less expensive grains. And that's why they don't use 100% malted barley. And I think that's really interesting. It then changes over to the United States, where obviously the soil and the land and the grains that are grown in the United States are going to be completely different than Scotland and Ireland. And that's why you get all kinds of different things like rye and corn that you find in American bourbon. And that's why in the United States, whiskey tastes a lot different than it does in Scotland or in Ireland. Difference number 5, the distilleries themselves. In Ireland, there's a really interesting story about the distilleries. There used to be loads of different distilleries all throughout Ireland. But during economic hardships, particularly during Prohibition in the United States, they had to consolidate to stay functioning. Nowadays, there are only three major distilleries in all of Ireland. They're Bushmills, Middleton, and Cooley. Bushmills was the first, which was founded in 1608. Now, we're starting to see a new renaissance within Irish whiskey, which is really exciting because it's great to see Irish whiskey extending out beyond those three distilleries. In Scotland, it's a completely different story. There are over 80 distilleries functioning in Scotland. The first, well, there's a lot of debate about what the first distillery in Scotland was. Most people tend to agree it was Little Mill, which was founded in 1772, but it's no longer running. So again, people will argue. If you disagree, leave your comments down below, but most people tend to agree that the oldest still operational distillery in Scotland is Glenturret, which was founded in 1775. But I am open for debate because I know people will disagree with that statistic. But the important fact is that there are over 80 distilleries, so you get a lot of variety and a lot of different distillations coming out of Scotland. In the United States, they first started making whiskey in Bourbon County, Kentucky. Nowadays, there are only 7 distilleries that are still in operation in Kentucky, and none of them are in Bourbon County. But all across the United States, they make some great whiskeys. Now, that is kind of unfair because the United States is a much bigger country than Ireland or Scotland, but it's interesting to see these diversities. So, Ireland, 3 distilleries, Scotland, over 80, Bourbon County, Kentucky, 0, Kentucky, 7, but for the rest of the United States, I don't even know how many distilleries there are. It's a good time to be drinking whiskey. So there you have it. 5 differences between whiskey and whisky. The 5 differences between Ireland, Scotland, and American whiskey. For more videos about whiskey, subscribe to Top Whiskies. We post new videos every week.